In this video, I'm going to talk about the language of the results section. Just to review, the results section is the third major section of your paper and contains the facts of your experimental results. First, let's talk about captions. Your tables and figures should be understandable without reading your paper. If you cut out the table or the graph, including its caption, someone with basic scientific knowledge should be able to understand what the question was and what the result is. Now look at this graph. It starts by saying mean stem length of seedling clover, so we know that we're measuring the stem length of clovers. Water to soil saturation daily for 2.5 weeks, so now we know what the treatment was, or how they did the experiment. With simulated acid rain of varying pH. Okay, so that's our independent variable, different pH. The control, pH 5.3, okay, so that's the control group. Was normal city tap water, and it tells you the pH 3.5 and 2.0 water and how they made that. Line over the bars, this indicates groups which are not significantly different, and it tells you the statistics test they use. And the number over the bar tells you the sample size, how many clovers there were in each group. So this caption is very clear and explains everything we need to understand this without reading the paper. For figures, the title and the caption comes below, and for tables, the title goes above. And sometimes there is extra information below the table. Now let's talk about the words that you need to describe your results. First, the results section uses these two tenses. You can see in this paper about the effect of different kinds of tea on catechin levels, that it uses past tense to talk about the results. Okay, consumption of green tea induced a significantly larger area. Okay, was not different. Okay, the rate of elimination of catechins from blood was significantly higher. Okay, addition of milk to black tea had no effect. There was no significant difference. On the other hand, present tense is used when you're talking about a table or a figure like this. Figure 1 shows the blood concentration, or the composition of green and black tea is shown in table 1. Okay, in the case of this paper, which is about the effect of different kinds of sounds on the behavior of gorillas, everything is in past tense. There was no significant effect. The animals tended to spend more of their time. These conditions encouraged more social interactions. Aggressive behaviors were reduced. In this paper, they don't actually refer to any of the tables by saying, like, table one shows, so there's no present tense. In the results section, you have to explain the trends and differences in your data. You'll need to explain both which direction the difference or change is and how big it is. In this example, larger explains the difference and significantly explains how big it is. In this one, 97 milliseconds is the amount and more is the direction of the difference. And in this last one, increased is the direction and marginally means a very small change. Okay, in the case of the gorilla paper, you can see the animals tended to spend more of their time resting and sitting, okay, than the control. Okay, also here, compared to the control, these conditions encouraged more social interactions, less moving and standing. Aggressive behaviors were reduced by, and then this is how much, amount of the change, by more than 50%. And in the case of abnormal behaviors, by more than 30%. And again, this is a good phrase, compared to the control. In the case of the tea paper, consumption of green tea induced a significantly larger area than black tea. Okay, the time to reach maximum concentration was not different, whereas the rate of elimination of catechins from blood was significantly higher as compared to black tea. Okay, here are some useful words that you can use to describe trends. These words describe the direction of the trend, And notice that we try to avoid using phrasal verbs like go up and instead use words like increase or rise. And these words can be used to describe how big the change is. For example, slightly is a small change. Scientific writing really likes big noun phrases. So sometimes we might change a sentence like this into one like this. Notice that the meaning is the same, but we converted the verb increased into the noun an increase, and we converted marginally into an adjective marginal. So increased marginally to there was a marginal increase. This is a very common pattern in academic writing. Okay, also you need to be specific about what you're talking about. In this example, it says the leaves changed more compared to those that received normal sunlight. But what about the leaves? We should write something like the color of the leaves or the texture of the leaves. Okay, notice that we write the color of the leaves and not the leaves' color. This is okay if it's a person or animal like the gorilla's color, but usually not for objects. This pattern, the something of the something, is very useful and used a lot in academic writing. Okay, just to review, you need to prepare a clear and complete caption for all of your figures and tables. Okay, use the present tense when you say something like figure one shows, but use the past tense for all the results of your experiment. Okay, next, explain the direction and magnitude of the changes and differences. And finally, try to use noun phrases like the something of the something.